This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so that was a small video about NDLI. I am sure there could be some technical glitch, but I think you can go to NDLI YouTube channel. There you can download the entire video. So I think still a few more people have joined. So let me start with basic rules of this webinar. One, kindly mute your audio. Two, kindly don't turn on your video. And three, don't share your screen. So if everybody, there are about 173 people in this webinar now, and if all of them turn on their audio, video, and screens, then it's going to consume a lot of bandwidth and it will completely destroy the entire webinar.
Yeah, no disturbance.
So kindly, kindly keep the mic mute in mute mode. So Dr. Shanti, is there a possibility that you can mute the, can you request the admin to mute everybody's mic except my mute, mic, because there is a lot of disturbance. I'm not. Thank you. So I think now let us start the session. So if you are able to see the presentation, kindly send me a chat message. Yes, visible. Only few of you. Okay, so thank you. So now, as you have said, it's visible. I will start the presentation. As Dr. Shanti mentioned, my name is Dr. Vignesh, and I'm part of the National Digital Library of India team, and I look after the outreach of NDLI. So before we begin the presentation, I just wanted to give you a brief background about NDLI. So actually, like, NDLI was conceived in the year 2014-15 by the then MHRD minister. Actually, like, the purpose was, during that time, even now, many of the centrally sponsored institutions, like all the IITs, IIMs, their library budget was anywhere between 15 crores to 25 crore rupees every year. And most of them are subscribing to the similar kind of resources, with some minor exceptions, and from the same, almost the same publisher. And also, so that time, like, these were very handful of number of institutions, maybe 20, 30 institutions. So the HRD minister asked, what could be the reason why these resources could not be shared with all the libraries or all the education institutions in this country. And why don't we create a platform of collating all these knowledge resources so that we can share it with everyone, every institution of this country. So that's when IIT Kharagpur jumped in, and led by Professor Partha Pratim Chakraborty and Partha Pratim Das, these two people conceived this idea of National Digital Library of India. And they started this initiative as a pilot project in 2016. With this background, now let's move on to the session. So what is the perspective of NDLI? So the perspective, if you can look at this India map, it shows the literacy rate of India as per 2011 census. So except very few states like Kerala, Goa, Mizoram and Tripura, where the literacy level is above 85% to 90%, in most of the states, in rest of the states, the literacy level is below 75%. Like you can imagine, like states like UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and other Rajasthan. So in these states, the literacy level is still very low. And also there is another like emerging statistics which says in India every month 10 lakh people are turning to an age of turning into an age of 18. That means they are getting into the higher education, they are in the age of getting into the higher educational. So in order to address that gap, educational gap, India needs to set up at least 6 universities and 270 colleges every month to address this education divide. So like for this, India would have to invest about 60,000 to 1 lakh crore every month only for creating the infrastructure. So that's the initial investment. Then you can imagine the sustenance of these institutions. So which would involve additional operational expenses every month. So that would lead to anywhere between 1.2 crore to 2 crore rupees, 2 lakh crore rupees every month. So if you also, if you look at it from the sustainability aspect of it, like to what extent these institutions would be sustainable, that is also a big question in front of us. So the government of India looked at having alternate solutions which can address the educational requirements. So that's when they looked at Swayam, Swayam Prabha, NPTEL, NDLIS, supplementing and complementing learning resource materials. So with this, the NDLI was launched, dedicated to the nation on 19th of June 2018. Right? Now, let us see what we have at NDLI. So at NDLI, we primarily have only the metadata. Right, and some of you may already know metadata is nothing but data about data. In a crude way, if you have to say it, it's basically the basic information about a resource. Say for example, if there is a book, if there is a book, and if you the basic information, like what is the type of the book, who is the author, who is the publisher, where is it published, so what is the subject it is covering, there is an abstract. So these are the basic information about the book, so that we call it as metadata, right? So the basic information about the resource is called metadata. We at NDLI primarily only have metadata. We don't store any full text. That means, say for example, if we collaborate with say Bharathiyar University, right? So what do we do is we like get into an agreement with Bharathiyar University, and then we help them in creating a metadata as per our metadata schema, and then we ingest only the metadata into our database, and whereas Bharathiyar University in their own server, they host the full text. So it technically means we only have metadata, and the original full text is available with Bharathiyar University. So we don't get into any copyright violation in this process, right? And as of now, metadata is non-copyrighted. So that is the situation as of now. And this is the use models that we follow. So first, how do we do is, say for example, we go to an institute, say for example, we go to Bharathiyar University, and we tell them like, we would like to collaborate. And if they are also interested in sharing their non-copyrighted open source resources, whether it could be a faculty publication or a student publication, right? Or any research publication. So then we help them in creating the institutional digital repository, and we give them, and then we ingest their metadata, right? And then we harvest the metadata into our database, right? And also what we do is, based on the metadata, we provide a front-end access for people to like search and use these metadata. And then wherever there is a requirement for full text, we redirect them back to the original source for accessing the full text. Okay, so now let's look at what are the types of content we store at or we have at in DLA. We don't store, sorry. We have at in DLA or through our partners. So primarily we have three types of full text. One is full text, one is like a bond digital object. This means, say for example, last year you submitted a thesis, you typed the entire thesis in a Word document, and then you converted this into a PDF, right? And then during the submission of your thesis, you gave the PDF file of your thesis to your college or university in a CD or a pen drive. So that is what then it was put into an online repository and it was linked to Shodhganga. So this is the bond, this means bond digital content object. That is, you have already created it in the digital format and then shared it with the institution for uploading. So that is bond digital. And second format is digital surrogate of a physical object. So I will give you an example for this. Say for example, 20 years back, when there was no computer available for typing the thesis, what could have happened is they could have got a typewriting done, or they might have written it by hand. These two things might have happened. And they gave the hard copy, submitted the hard copy to the corresponding college or university. And what, so now it is, now, suppose if it is now available in printed format, then what happens is like we scan these resources and then put it as a PDF format, in a PDF format. Now this is called digital surrogate of a physical object. Okay, and the third one is only metadata. We create only the metadata of a physical object. We don't give the full text. So these are the three types of content that we have at NDLA. And now let's look at how do we operate. As I mentioned, we don't create any content or we don't scan any content. How do we work is we work as an integrator. We work as a integrating platform. So how do we do it? We actually collaborate with various educational research and publishing institutions, right? So say for example, like Bardia University, IITs, IIMs, NITs, all these research institutions supported by the government, all these educational institutes of various central government as well as state governments. So we have collaborated with around 278 content contributors so far. And what types of content we have at NDLA? I will just show you. So computer science, information, and general works, we have closer to 99 lakh resources. Philosophy and psychology is about 6 lakhs. 2 lakh resources available on religion. Social sciences, 45 lakhs. Language, 1 lakh. Natural sciences and mathematics, 83 lakhs. Technology, 1 crore. The arts, fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakhs. Literature and rhetoric, 7.8 lakhs. History and geography, 6.1 lakhs. So this is the kind of resources we have. This is as per the DDC classification. And who are those top 20 content contributors to NDLA? World eBook Library. They have contributed the highest. In fact, Government of India has procured national license from World eBook Library, and we have closer to 77 lakh resources from library, followed by Site CRX, 50-30 lakhs. Let's check the other. Resources. Presentation. With the content contributors of NDLA. In fact, I will share this patient with Dr. Shanti. She might also send you, and I will send you a follow-up email as well. And then what type of content we have at NDLA? So you like me, we have a range of article starting from an notebook, lecture, video lecture, class, stream papers, assignments, lab experiments, manuals, manuscripts, thesis, dissertation, that is available. Any form of educational resource that NDLI. And article dominates the list of resources with two out of so we have as of now 4 courses as of yesterday, and out of which 2.97 crore resources are articles, followed by reports are about 12 lakhs, notes 11 lakhs, law 8.7 lakhs, law judgments 8.7 lakhs, technical report lakhs, lakhs, video collection, which is 6.41 lakhs, article records 5.3 lakhs, 0.62 lakhs. And then 8 lakh resources out of the resources. And how do we find full text resources? So actually you can full text and see under each, when you search, you will see stuff. Search research, and the first type, there is an access option, whether it is an open source or closed, so that you can identify from this icon. Suppose lock is open, and also if there is a rectangle box with NDLI written on it, or a person written on it, what is entire book or article or video, mobile phone, and then use them to your computer or a free of cost without. So as I mentioned, education purposes only. Okay. There are about 3.6 crore resources, which are resources. Open resources are NDLI resources are 77 lakh resources, 0.74 resources. Test of the resources, you can check subscribed resources or check like Springer. These are all this content meant for. So NDLI content is meant for right studying students to college going preferring to work, and then academicians or researchers, anybody who is interested in learning, they can actually use NDLI. So you can actually see, just a moment, let me audio. Is my audio better now?
Sir, not clear, sir. Audio is not clear,
okay.
Sir.
Clear, sir.
Clear, sir.
Okay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Clear only. Fine. I think the wherever there is a connective issue there, the audio might be some problem. So okay. So now I will move ahead. So now let us see how to access NDLI. Accessing NDLI is very easy, right? How to do it? Go to Google, and then type National Digital Library of India. In this case, you can go to any browser or any search engine. Just type National Digital Library of India, and the first URL you get is this ndl.iitkgp.ac.in, and we have another URL which is ndl.gov.in. So whichever, you can use any one of these URLs. So suppose if you want to open this page, just click on this. Once you click, this is how our home page looks like. So this is the home page of NDLI. Okay, so our team, this pop-up window opens one like very recently, so you can just close this window and then see our home page. So in order to search for a resource, how do we do it? So on the top, you will see a search box. Okay, this is called search box. So here you can search for the topic. Okay, for using NDLA, you just need to remember two important things. One, you should know how to choose your search topic. So for example, here I have typed history of English literature. Okay, suppose if I put only English literature, then I look for history of English literature, it would be difficult. So you have to be very precise in choosing your search topic. And also you need to remember the correct spelling of it. Suppose if you make a spelling error, say for example, literature, if you put L-E, then there will be a mismatch in the results. So you have to be very clear and particular about the search topic and the spelling of this thing. This is the first one you should remember, right? So once you type, click here, this is the search icon, just click here, and then the results will appear. Now the second thing you need to do is, in order to further narrow down the results, you can apply various filters. So on the left hand side, you can see a lot of filters that you can use to narrow down your results. So here I have clicked for a filter called subject category. Okay, so I chose language and literature. I wanted it from both the disciplines. So I got 6.74 lakh resources on the topic of history of English literature. Okay, so this is how you have to use. And there are other filters like access restriction, author, subject category, educational degree, difficulty level, educational level, file format, language, learning resource type, and source. On the right hand side also, we have a filter called content type. And the next topic I searched was modern India. Okay, here I applied two filters. The first filter I applied was access restriction, where I applied only NDLA and open. I clicked on NDLA and open. That means I wanted only the full text resources so that I can download and use it. And then I wanted under the subject category of history and geography. So I got 20,000 resources on the topic of modern India. And the next topic I searched was Indian constitutional law. Okay, I applied full text by choosing access restriction, open and NDLA. I got 31 lakh results in the topic of Indian constitutional law. And the next topic I searched was banking law under the subject category of social sciences. I got 14 lakh resources on the topic of banking law. And the next topic I searched was 1984. So that is one of those top 10 novels in the world. So I searched 1984 under the subject category of literature and rhetoric, and I wanted only full text resources, okay, from NDLA resources. And I got the original source of written by 1984 for resource was written by George Orwell. That's a full text is available under NDLA of source of World eBook Library, and this is available in various language, Hungarian and English also. We have both the language of this material. And the next topic I searched was on sociology. Okay, here I wanted resources which are only video lectures. So what I did was, on the right hand side, there is a content type filter under which I chose videos. So I got 455 video lectures on the topic of sociology. And the next topic I searched was on microeconomics. Okay, and then here I wanted the resources only from Asim Premji Foundation and MIT OpenCourseWare. So I got 251 results on the topic of microeconomics. Then I searched for a topic called human physiology. Okay, again I wanted only video lectures, so I clicked on content type video. I got 12,788 video lectures on the topic of human physiology. Then I searched for a topic called engineering mechanics. This time I wanted it from a specific author of Sudarshan Iyengar. Okay, so I went to author and then I searched for Sudarshan Iyengar. I got 862 video lectures on the topic of engineering mechanics. And the next topic I searched was artificial intelligence. And I wanted source of from only the source of MIT open courseware and the subject category of computer science and technology. So I got 64 and also content type video lectures. So I got 64 video lectures on the topic of artificial intelligence from MIT open courseware. And the next topic I searched was effective parenting. Here I wanted only audio files. Okay, so what I did was searched for effective parenting and then went to file format. I chose MP3 files. Okay, then I got 6584 audio files on the topic of effective parenting. Then I searched for a topic of pedagogy under the subject category of social science and a specific author of Bert Payne. So I got 8 results on the topic of pedagogy. And then I searched for a topic called rural marketing. Here I clicked only open and NDLA resources. I got 6.3 lakh resources. So you can also further narrow down these results by clicking on the subject category and then learning resource type, source, language. Suppose if you want language of only Hindi, you can search. You can go to language and then apply Hindi. Suppose if you want it in Telugu, go to language and then type Telugu. If the resource is available, you will definitely get the resource in your own language also. Okay, so now let us see, as I earlier mentioned, during this time of lockdown due to Corona virus, COVID-19 virus spread, our team has further classified the resources into various educational level and also disciplines. So what you could how you can access this is, go to home page. On the top you will see this icon, red color icon with Corona outbreak study from home written there. You have to just click here. Once you click, this pop-up window appears. Here you can see school, UG engineering, UG science, UG other disciplines, language, management and law. So whichever you want, you can just click and go further to look for the resources. And also our team has put together various research resources on the COVID-19 virus also. So if you want to access or know anything further about COVID-19 virus, you can just click this COVID-19 research resources, then you can use that thing. Suppose here I have clicked on UG engineering. Okay, then I can see all the subjects, common subjects which are uniform to all the engineering disciplines, and then aerospace engineering, architecture, chemical, civil, computer science, electrical, electronics and communication, mechanical, mining, ocean and technical engineering. So these are the subjects that are available. Now let us see how to open a resource in NDLA. So here I searched for a topic called research methodology. Okay, and then I wanted resources only from the source of Lovely Professional University. So what I did was went to source, type Lovely Professional University, and then I got 1438 results. Suppose if I have to open the first resource, what I need to do is just click on this research methodology. Once I click, this page will open. Okay, so here there are two tabs. The first tab is called content and the second tab is called metadata. So first click on the metadata. As I mentioned, metadata is nothing but basic information about that resource. So here the basic information is, what is the title of the resource? Where is the source coming from? Who? What type of content it is? Who is the publisher? What is the file format? Language? All these informations are metadata. And here you have to check access restriction, whether it is a open NDLA resource or it's a subscribed resource. Suppose if it's an open NDLA resource, then you can download. And also you need to check, suppose if you have already logged in. So here I have logged in as Vignesh Swarnamohan. So I can, when I click on the content, I will get the entire 338 page of the book in my desktop or laptop or in your mobile phone. Clear? So here I have already logged in, so I could download. Suppose if I have not logged in, when I click on content, this kind of a page will open. Here it will ask me to first log in. Please log in to view this content. Then only you will be able to view or download the content. So what you can do is just click on this login. Once you click on this login, there will be a pop-up window like this will open. This is the pop-up window. So here, suppose if you are already registered with NDLA and if you know your email ID and password, just put your email ID and password, enter the captcha and click login. Then you will be able to download or read the resources in your desktop or mobile phone. Suppose you forgot your password, okay, then click on account recovery and then type your email ID and then submit. Then you will get an password reset option so that you can reset your password and re-login to your account. So that's the second option. And the third option is, suppose if you have never logged in or never registered with the NDLA, what you can do is you can actually register yourself or sign up. There will be two options, either sign up or register. So just click on this icon, then this registration form will open, right? So here you have to enter your full name, email ID, password, and confirm password. These are the four mandatory fields that you have to fill. Rest of the fields like date of birth, gender, state, city, educational role, these are all optional, which you can fill even at a later stage also. Kindly mute your mic.
Class
Dr. T. Dhanalakshmi, kindly mute your mic. Dr. T. Dhanalakshmi, Dr. T. M. K. Amuda, please mute your mic. There is going to be disturbance. There is a disturbance here. Admin, can you mute their? Okay, so thank you. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Audible. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes sir.
So for registration,
yes, sir.
Just fill. Fine. So for registration, you just have to enter your full name, email ID, password, and confirm password. Then rest of the fields are optional fields only. You just have to enter these details and then submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification email from our NDL support email ID. You have to just verify your email. Then you can come back and log in with your email ID and password, and then you can download the entire resource at free of cost. Suppose if it's a video lecture, this is how the video lecture will open. So this is how the video lecture will open in your system. So as I mentioned, for using NDLA, it's very easy. You need to remember only two things. One, as I earlier mentioned, you need to know the exact search topic with correct spelling. That is one. Second thing you need to remember is the various filter option that you can use to narrow down your search results. So here I'm going to talk about the important filter option that you may want to use during your search. The first filter option that you may want to remember is access restriction. Suppose if you want only full text resources, just click on open and NDLA, then you will get full text resources. You will be able to download all the resources which comes under open and NDLA access restriction. And the second filter is author. You search the topic and look for the author. Suppose if you want the author of Zhangwei, just choose here, then you will get the corresponding author. And the third filter is subject category. Depending on the your search topic, you have to choose the subject category. Suppose if you are looking for artificial intelligence, either it could come under computer science or technology. So you have to choose these two. Suppose if you look for artificial intelligence in human physiology, then it will come under also technology, natural sciences, and computer science. So you have to be very careful in choosing the subject category. And the next filter is about file format, important filter. Suppose if you want only PDF files, go to file format and then choose PDF. Suppose if you want MP3 files, which are audio files, then you can choose here. Suppose if you want only video files, choose MP4 or MP4, MPEG4. So these are the file format options. And the fifth filter is language option. Suppose if you want Hindi, just go to language and then type Hindi. Just type Hindi and then choose Hindi language. You will be able to see only resources from Hindi, available in Hindi. Suppose if you want resources only in Tamil, just go here and then type Tamil. You will get resources from on the topic, whatever resources available in Tamil. So likewise, you can choose the language of your choice and then accordingly download the resource. And the sixth filter is learning resource type. Suppose if you want only audiobook, just click here. Suppose if you want only book, go here and type book. You will get the book option. Just choose it and then apply. Then you will get books. And the next seventh filter, that the important filter that you may have to remember is source. As I mentioned, there are about 278 content partners we have at NDLA. So you can check which are the content sources from where you want the content. Suppose if you want the content from Bloomsbury, just click here Bloomsbury, then you will get sources only from Bloomsbury. And the last important filter that I wanted to know is the content type filter, which is available in the desktop application on the right hand side. This is for easy purpose. Suppose if you want video files, just click, go here and click video, then you will get only video lectures on the topic of your choice. So this is the filter option that I wanted you to remember. And the next important aspect is you can actually use the entire interface of NDLA in your own language also. Currently it's available in Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Marathi, Kannada, Oriya, and Tamil. So how you can do is go to the home page. On the top you will see the language interface. Just click the down arrow and then you will be able to see various Indian interlanguage. So you can choose the language and then the entire interface will translate into your own language and then you can use the resources. And for the ease of using, our team has developed the NDL website into a mobile app also. So you can actually download it. It's available both in Android as well as in iOS. Okay, now you can download the app and use it in your mobile also. So you can access, you can go to the Play Store and then type National Digital Library of India and the first URL, like this is the name of the app and this is the publisher and this is how the logo looks like. So you can see this and then install it in your mobile phone. Now let us see how to use the NDLA app, Android app. Now let us see and then we will do a small activity. Right, so this is the home page. The first screen is the home page of NDLA Android app. On the second screen, it shows how to search a topic in your mobile app. So on the top there is a icon for search. Okay, so just click on this icon, then this search box will appear. Whereas in the desktop application, search box will be appearing constantly, but in the mobile app only you have to click on this search icon, then only this search box will appear. So you have to, so here I have entered the topic called Uttar Pradesh. So once I entered in the keypad itself, I clicked on search and I got 41,573 results on Uttar Pradesh, right? So now if I want to filter the resources, what I have to do is, on the right bottom corner, there is this orange color icon. Just click on this icon, then the filters will appear. So you can see on the third screen, all the filters which we saw on the desktop application might appear on the top. It appears on the top. So here you can see source, content type, access restriction. For seeing the other filters, you just have to scroll these app. Just scroll this section, then you will see the remaining filters also. So now what I did was, I went to the source tab and then clicked on Aligarh Muslim University. So I wanted the source, the only from in resources from Aligarh Muslim University, and then I apply, then I got 199 results on the topic of Uttar Pradesh from the source of Aligarh Muslim University. Okay, so this is how you have to use the NDLI mobile app. Okay, so now we are going to do a small activity. So I'm going to pass my presentation for 5 minutes. Now it's 3:16 in my system. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. What I'm going to request you is, kindly go to Play Store or iStore, whichever. If you are using an Android phone, go to a Play Store and then search for the topic of National Digital Library of India. Okay, search for the topic of National Digital Library of India, and then the first icon, like you can see the NDLI icon, download that app and install it in your mobile phone.
Right, already that is the done, first task.
Okay, if you have already done, then what I request you to do is search for the topic of your subject of study or your teaching. So I want you to search the topics which you are teaching or you are studying. You search and then give me the feedback whether it is useful or not, or if you are not useful, kindly give me the reason for it. And you have to put, you have downloaded the app. If you have downloaded, yes, just put down, downloaded the app, and which topic you searched for and whether that was useful or not. So I want you to put it in the chat message. And I have one more request to all of you. If you can turn on your video, I can take, or we can take few screenshot of the participants for reporting purposes. So you can turn on. Now it's 3:17. We will take 5 minutes. So we will be starting the resuming back the session in 5 minutes, which is 22. Okay, and also you can turn on the videos for next 5 minutes, so that we can take few screenshot of the participants. Thank you. And you have 5 minutes.
Hello. Hello. Hello, sir.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Yeah, yeah, I can hear.
Hello, sir.
Can I ask a question, sir?
No, don't ask questions now. Questions we will take it at the end. If you have pressing question, kindly put it in the chat. Because if everybody, there are about 200 people, if everybody start asking question now, it will be a complete confusion. I just want all of you to kindly mute your mic. Question and answer we will take after the session is over. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
So kindly mute your mic, and if possible, if you are comfortable, you can turn on your video so that I can take some screenshot of the participants.
Hello.
Sir, please tell me again which app we have to download it. Again, tell me please. Audio is
National.
Your voice is not audible.
National Digital Library of India. Go to Play Store.
go to Play Store and search for National Digital Library of India, and then you have to download that and install that app.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Kindly mute your mic, sir. Okay, so Ms. Purnima has searched for C book and she got the entire full text. Somebody Pranav Jana, she searched for composite materials and she found the resources useful.
Sir, we want to log in,
huh? Yeah, yeah. So kindly, if you have, if you remember your username and password, kindly log in. If you have not registered, kindly register and then log in. Okay.
Okay, sir. Mm-hmm. Great, panna chollide.
Hello. Can you hear me? This is Tamare. I've downloaded the app and searched my thing. Hello.
Okay, so kindly put it in the chat message because there will be a lot of people speaking. So they see the chat message. Chat message. Kindly, all of you, kindly mute your mic. There is some disturbance. Kindly mute your mic.
See, if we copy the content from your recorder, it didn't show up.
Okay, so search for Apurva Verma, search for poverty in India, SIM install, usually very full, many resources, sir. Big data analytics, somebody did search on big data analytics, somebody searched for research methodology. Amarnath Pati searched for SHRD practices and it's very useful. I'm Dr. Savita Sharma, found useful material in mindfulness. Very good, Dr. Savita Sharma. Anupriya searched and downloaded the app, searched for artificial intelligence and found it useful. Thank you, Anupriya, for the feedback. Athena, smart classrooms. Okay. Dr. M. Prakash, I need specific feedback. Somebody, yes, Dr. S. Karthik Sadaraman searched for financial management. Good. Yuvashri searched for mythology and she got the results. That's wonderful. Dr. Anita Gangade, how many resources available in NDLA app? Good. So Dr. Anita, we have closer to 4.8 crore resources, and soon we will have 5 crore resources at NDLI. And Mr. Logu searched for wireless sensor networks, and I'm registered, and he got full book of on the topic of wireless sensor networks. Very good. Kindly mute your mic, please. You put chat message, that is far better. Just put it in the chat. I'm reading each one. Dr. S. Salvi searched for CK chain technology. It's so useful, and she found it very useful. Dr. S. Salvi. And then Miss Nalini searched for financial management, and she got the full book. Okay. Now let's go from Miss Suganya searched for ancient India, and she found the entire resource. And Dr. R. Nandakumar found resources on network security. Very good. Integrated marketing communication, Mr. KVL downloaded it. Corporate accounting, Dr. M. Nirmala found it. Machine learning, somebody searched on machine learning, emotional intelligence, globalization of HRM, robotic applications, big data analytics. Yes. Okay. So I think you have done a great job, and I request each one of you, if you are now, you can turn off your video, because I've taken some screenshots, which will be helpful. Now I request all of you to turn off your video, and I'm going to request each one of you, if you're researched, used NDLI app, and if you're finding it useful, now I request all of you to spread this word. And currently we are about 215 people in this webinar. And if each one of you, if you forward this useful resource, because it's not going to cost any money for you or any money for any of the people who are going to use it, if you forward it to at least 100 people, and we are 215 people here, we can easily reach 21,000 people in the next half an hour, right? So the best service that we can do to humanity is spread knowledge. So we can actually spread knowledge using this NDLI resources. So may I request all of you to take a pledge that you will spread at least to 100, either it could be your family, it could be your friends, family members, relatives, or your students, or your neighborhood people. May I request kindly put it in mute?
Yes.
Yeah. So okay, I request each one of you to kindly spread this message. So just you have to go to Play Store or iStore, and there is an option called share. So just click on the share button, and then you can share it in the various WhatsApp group that you are member of. Okay, then you will be easily reaching out to 100 people in the next half an hour. So that is possible. We can easily reach out to 21,000 people. And also you can imagine, each of you may be teaching or be a librarian in some institution or studying for your PhD. You may be connected with so many people. And also spread this message to each one of your college or students or friends at your earliest convenience. So this is my humble request. Now we will resume the session.
Hello. Participants?
Yes.
Do you have any questions?
Yes, sir.
Can we take the question? Hello? Can we take the questions at the end, if it's not a problem for you?
Hello. Sir, Vignesh, sir.
Can I ask?
Can we take the question?
Ah, okay, sir. No problem.
Okay. Let's take the questions at the end. Kindly okay, keep it in your mind, okay, because we have few more slides to see, and then we will take the questions together. Thank you. So now let us see, what is the major difference between NDLI and Google? And now let's see it with a quick example. So imagine there is a girl called Payal and another guy called Shamik, and they are Payal is in class 8 and she is studying in Hindi medium. And she wants to know about asthma in the center. It is in the center. He is applying for PhD positions in one of those institutions in the country, and he is more keen to PhD on the topic of. Just a moment. Is it okay now?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, sir. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Proceed, sir.
So both of them are interested in the topic of magnetism. So what they did was they both went to Google. They searched for the topic. Mr. Selvakumar, kindly mute your mic. And then they searched for the topic of they searched for the topic of magnetism and they got 1.89 crore results.
Okay.
And then they came to NDLI and they searched for the topic called magnetism and they got 11 lakh resources. Now, what Payal did was she applied two filters. One is she applied educational level, 5th to 8th standard, and then language Hindi. She got 8 results. Okay. We can imagine where is 1.89 crore and where is 8. And then what Shamik did was he applied for career and technical papers and he got 219 results. Now let us see what is the major difference between Google and NDLI. The first and foremost difference is Google does its job brilliantly. There is no competition with Google and NDLI, between Google and NDLI. Google does its job brilliantly and there is no competition to it as of now. And what Google does in its operation is, suppose if you put the term called magnetism, it will go around the entire World Wide Web, and wherever this term called magnetism is there, it will fetch the results, right? And it can't understand it. It doesn't distinguish whether it's coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether it's a real information or a fake information, whether it is relevant for the searching person or not. So it can't distinguish all these things, and then it will fetch whether it's an educational resource or a non-educational resource. It can't distinguish between all these. It will fetch all the information. Okay. Whereas at the NDLI, we actually partnered with only educational, reputed educational research and publishing industry, and only people who are in the educational domain. So all our content are curated from the source itself. They are only meant for educational purposes, right? And the second difference is, at the NDLI, you can filter down the results based on your requirement. That option is not available at Google. And you can also do the user experience tracking at NDLI, which is not possible at Google. And the last important thing is, at the NDLI, we started procuring national licenses. National license means the government of India, on behalf of the Indian citizens, pay to the publishers and issues these resources to Indian citizens at free of cost. So that's what it means. And government of India has already procured national license from two publishers. One is World Ebook Library, another one is South Asia Archives. And this is some basic statistics about the NDLI. And what is the big picture? So already you have this credit transfer and virtual certification scheme under which you can augment about 20 credits from like MOOC courses like SWAM, NPTEL, SWAM Prabha and Khyang. And maybe in the 5 years or 10 years down the line, if you have the access to digital devices and internet, you can actually get a school or certificate or diploma or UG or PG degree by sitting at your home only with the use of technology. So this may or may not happen. I'm not saying it will happen. It may or may not happen. Now let us look at how to operate NDLA club in your institution. And before we see that, let's see why NDLA club. So I keep sharing this my experience. So I visited a college. There I was telling in the meeting that so nowadays the students read very use technology for other purposes, and they use technology very limited way for reading or studying. So the principal said, no, you are wrong. You are wrong. You have our students use the technology extensively for studying only. So I said, I will go with your students in the evening in their bus. So he said, okay, you go. So I went went and sat in their bus. So there is some disturbance. Is there some mic? Dr. Shadish Kumar. Dr. Shadish Kumar, आपका माइक अनम्यूट किया हुआ है, म्यूट कीजिए.
एडमिन उन्होंने कभी भी एससी एसटी ओबीसी भाइयों का या बहनों का भला नहीं चाहा है. मैं मध्य प्रदेश के तमाम
सर प्लीज
सर आई कांट हियर यू सर.
हेलो सर.
नो नो देयर इज सम डॉक्टर सतीश कुमार.
यस सर. सतीश कुमार सर उस पर है
क्योंकि
हेलो.
So kindly mute him or remove him from the group. Admin.
So, Adesh Kumar.
Hello, sir.
Kindly, admin, kindly mute all the mics.
Hello, sir. Hey, Vignesh, sir.
Tulunga, madam.
Sir.
Our mic unmute. Mute, pannirunga, madam.
और इन पेर पर
डॉक्टर सतीश कुमार
हाई कोर्ट निकाल कर बाहर फेंकने की कवायद दिया हुआ है.
मीटिंग में मैं मत मुड़ रहा
हूं. की बातें भी सुनी थी कि भैया सामान्य वर्ग में सामान्य वर्ग के बच्चों से कंपटीशन नहीं कर सकते. और आज जब कंपटीशन हुआ तो मैंने देखा
अभी तो
सुप्रीम कोर्ट या हाई कोर्ट जैसे लोग में अपने ही जजमेंट देकर इस तरह से घिनौना काम किया जा रहा है और आरक्षण से बाहर कर रहे हैं.
I mean, please mute everyone and then unmute my mic only.
सर प्लीज मी एडमिन यू कैन म्यूट अदर्स.
यार अपना फायदा लेंगे और हमारी बहनें उस सीटों पर अगर
सर अटेंड कर यू म्यूट ऑल अटेंडेंट.
ओके सो आई माय सिंसियर रिक्वेस्ट काइंडली डोंट अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. There was a lot of disturbance. Okay, now let us resume the session. So I was telling you about my experience. So I sat in the bus, college bus, and like as soon as the bus got full, there were about 50-55 people in the bus, and most of them were students with some faculty members also. And as soon as they boarded, there were three or four group of people. As soon as they boarded the bus, they took out their mobile phone, and most of them have a high speed internet connection, so they either watch Netflix or they do movie downloading or movie watching. That is one they most of them, at least 50% of the people do. And the second group of people do was like they put on their earphone and they either listen to your music or they talk to someone whom the God only knows. So that's second. And the third group of people as soon as they boarded the bus, they must have been tired and they go to sleep. So these were the three group of people who I could see in that bus. But they use the technology or mobile phone using for educational purposes. That they use technology exactly 2 or 3 days before the examination. Even in some cases, it's one day before the examination. How they use is one brilliant student or one brilliant faculty member, he or she takes the notes and they circulate all the important questions and notes to the WhatsApp group of the class, and everybody reads it and then they go and appear for the examination. So that is how they use technology for reading. So then I came back and gave this feedback to the principal, and he said he will do something about it, but I'm not sure whether he has done something to address this issue. And wherever I went, I shared this experience. Majority of the students and the faculty members and the librarians agreed, yes, this is what the situation is. And now the government also looked at this as a major challenge. So they looked at having the culture of promoting the culture of reading. So they looked at various institutional mechanism, and then they said NDLA club is one form of kickstarting that process of promoting the culture of reading. So the process is how we proposed is at least one student from each class and one faculty member from each department, with librarian as the ex officio secretary and principal as the ex officio chairman of the club. So you form this club, get this list approved, and then you upload it on the NDLA club registration form. Once you upload, we verify it, and then we issue a, this is how the registration form looks like. You have submit this. Once you upload, we issue a certificate of registration, and this is valid for 1 year. And within 1 year, what you need to do is the first 30 days, what you need to do is spread this NDLA to all the students and faculty members in the campus. So how you can do is you can you have NDLA club members who are from each class and each department, and then you can conduct an awareness session for them, and they in turn go back and conduct an awareness session for their fellow students and faculty members. And then you can do bulk registration of all the students and faculty members by collecting three details. First is you need to collect their personal email ID, and then first name, and then last name. You collect these three details of all the students and faculty members in the campus. And then you have to send this Excel file to this email ID of ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in. ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in with a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in and vignesh@gmail.com. This is my personal email ID. So once you send it to us, we do a bulk registration and you get a automatic verification email. And what you need to do is there is a temporary password given. Just click on that URL and log in with your, by default you will be logging in with your email ID. You enter this temporary password, then you will be asked to reset your password. You just enter a new password, confirm password, and you are all set to go. So this will help when the UGC NAC or AICT approval time, renewal or verification time, when you they will ask for digital resources. And there is a question for NDLA also. Suppose if you show them that you are an NDLA club member and you have registered so many people under NDLA and so many of them have activated NDLA, then you will get the 2 point additional for becoming an NDLA club member. Say for example, now you go to your home. So now you have gone out of your college. Say now you go back home, you have young children at home, and they are studying in schools, or you have relatives who are studying in colleges, or friends who wants to learn something new. So for them, they can do individual registration also. So how they can do is go to our homepage, and on the right bottom corner, you can see there is this register icon where I have circulated in red that icon. If you click on this register button, then our registration page will open. So this is how the registration page looks like. So here you have full name, enter your full name, email ID, password, and confirm password. These are the four details which are mandatory. Okay, and then rest of the details you can fill, or we'll fill it later also. And then you have to submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification email, and then you have to verify that email, then come back and log in with your email and ID and password. Then you can access all the resources at free of cost. So this is the first part. So within 30 days, you have to register all the students and faculty members within 30 days. And then you have to conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities. Some of the activities that you can do is a lecture series, or a quiz competition, or a storytelling session, or a go fish session, or a film screening session, or a debate competition, drawing competition, role play, write on, writing competition, maker space. So these are all some of the indicative activities that you can do. So after the end of each activity, you need to upload the report of this event in our registration form. So then you will be at the end of 1 year, we will review your activities, and then we will issue a certificate of renew your certificate of registration. And these are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLA clubs of across the country. And PSGR Krishnamal College's NDLA club is very active, and they have done a lot of activities in the last, I think, almost 15 months or so. They are one of the best clubs that is performing well. So where to start? You can start with identifying the NDLA club members, and then submit an online application form. Then conduct an awareness session for your own NDLA club members. Register all the students and faculty members, and conduct my regular monthly reading and related activity. And also, we are looking at recognizing the best performing NDLA club at the district, state, and national level also. And so recently GMHRD has formed it's still in the draft stage. They are looking at incentivizing the best performing NDLA club also with some financial support. So soon the notification will be issued, then we will get to know about it in the due course. And also we are looking at organizing reading will be NDLA. Again, thanks to Dr. Shanti and Dr. Batmavati, we organized the NDLA reading will be for months back for district. We have had conducting state level beginning that we are looking at, and national level reading Olympiads also, NDLA club reading Olympiads. So I'm going to give you my Mohan, and the email is ignesh.gov.in. Ignesh J.
Okay, sir.
NU at gmail.com. Email ID is vcom, and my mobile number is 9999655. So if you want to set up 5-8 club in your any awareness session for your own institution, or if you want to contact institution, so kindly send me an email. Mostly I emails, if you can send me an message. So message get back available for call. That's a message whenever I back to you. And for bulk registration, we'll get you can contact my ndl-kgp.ac.in. Okay, so with this, I thank everyone who wasn't here, and Shantra Bhatti for on this request webinar. If we can, and it would be useful to put the questions in the chat message so that I can respond, and there will be also. Okay, so chat would be better.
Hello
sir, put no, sir. Chat messages.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Can I ask question, sir? Hello, sir. Pranam, sir.
Sir, kindly put it in the chat, sir. That would. There is lot of disturbance, sir. Sir, kindly put it in the chat message. So I will putting my email ID and mobile number in that also. Can put your questions in the Do we have any charges for becoming the club? No. Ms. Sushma Chawla, there is no finance involved for starting an NDLA club in your own institution. It's completely free of cost. Okay. Thank you, sir. We learned a lot. So where is the share option, as you mentioned, sir? Share option, I didn't mention about. Mr. Rajendran Maha, I didn't mention about share option. How to become a life member? One time registration. Once you register on NDLA app and you are a lifetime member, videos and audios, mathematics are available. Yes, Dr. V. Anandaswamy. Yes, we have huge repository of videos on mathematics and all the subjects. Thank you for thanks for Abhinesh for the presentation. Thank you very much for your time and session. Thank you. Okay. See, membership of NDLA is useful to everyone. See, because you have resources at your fingerprints, 4.8 crore resources. That much resources, if you have to collate, you need to invest anywhere between 400 to 500 crore resource rupees to collate these resources. Okay, so there is Dr. Shanti Rangasamy from Kamadenu College, Satya Mangalam. We are interested in open a club in our college. Will you inaugurate the club? It depends on the time. So when you open, if I'm around in that area, then I will come down and inaugurate. Otherwise, you have some good people. So Dr. Shanti, Dr. Padmavati, these are people who are veterans in this. They know this, how to run this club. And Dr. Shanti and Dr. Padmavati, they've done amazing work. So you should get in touch with them. They will be able to help you in starting the NDLA club. So Ms. Revati, any membership fee? No membership fee, ma'am. Ajit Kumar, thank you. Okay. So thank you messages we can put at the end. If you have questions, kindly put it. So only librarian contact for bulk registration or anybody on behalf of college. As long as you are interested in taking forward NDLA resources, you can write to us and we would be happy to help you. Not necessarily librarians. Can we share? There is a question from Mr. Amarnath Pati. Can we share, upload our research articles on or books on etc. in NDLA? Sir, it's currently we are working with only institutions. Suppose if your institution is interested in sharing the resources, we'd be happy to do. Individuals, we are doing it, but at a very limited level. Maybe you can send me an email. I will connect you with the appropriate team member. They will help you, sir. So there is a question from Vidyut Prabha Jaina. Sir, how to search for research papers from it, Springer or IEEE? Simple. Put the topic, go to source, check IEEE or check Springer. You will get appropriate sources from the resources. So for your information, for IEEE and Springer, we only have metadata. We don't have the full text. Only librarian is the secretary. What about other faculty members in position? See, this is just an indicative idea. What you can also do is, it depends on your institution. Suppose if you want any faculty member also to act as co-secretary or secretary, that is up to you. So you can come up with, the principal can suggest, or you can come up with your own idea. So we don't have any restriction. As long as your vision is clear, if you want to create the culture of reading, and if you take forward NDLA resources to all the entire student community and the faculty community, whoever does it, we don't bother. We're not only made us aware, but made us to create awareness about it. Thank you, Dr. Randolph, for the NDLA-level exam. Yes, we have played in the exam. Yes, we have plenty of materials available for net exam. You can read it. Sage publications in NDLA? No, we have Sage publications at the site, but not satisfied with accessibility. So, Sami, thank you for feedback. Kindly send me an separate message with your feedback and the screenshot so that I can take it with my team. See, we are also in the process of learning. We are not somebody who has come back from moon. We are also human beings. We make mistakes. We learn on our mistakes and we rectify the mistakes. So if there is any feedback that you want to give us, kindly give it to us. We would be happy to. Me and my team are brilliant. And our team is led by Professor Chakravarti, Professor Das, Mr. Nandkopal Chattopadhyay. All these people are very open to having constructive criticisms, and they are willing to make all the changes required. Yes, Mr. HP, yes, these you can access. For history of India, we need more books in NDLA, sir. It's a request. So kindly give the request in the mail so that I can forward it to my team. And if you all have suggestions, kindly put it. Which are the resources that you want to put? Dr. R. Nandakumar, once we is it possible to sir, become admin, sir, for other participations? Yes, madam.
Beginning, sir. Sorry, wind up.
Yes.
Please, participants. Thank you, Vignesh sir, for your wonderful session and sharing useful information to the participants. I thank our management, secretary madam, principal madam, for organizing this webinar. I thank all the participants for your patient listening. So thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you all the participants. If you have any questions, please mail to us.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Participants. When will start the question? Quiz, ma'am. Hello.
Ma'am, just a minute, ma'am. Can I have all questions, please?
Thank you, ma'am.
When will start quiz? You, ma'am. Quiz timing, ma'am.
Sir, we will send you ma'am. Assignment link. 5 minutes.
Thank you so much.
Okay, ma'am. Again, you will send our way. We can use the old one.
Check your mail.
Thank you for the wonderful session.
You, morning, already I sent the mail to you. Please check the link. Okay. Thank
very
you.
Very nice. Session.
Thank you for the wonderful session.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your wonderful session, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful session. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Vignesh, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, organizer and resource person.
Thank you, sir, for organizing. Thank you for organizing this wonderful session. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for all the committee members.
Thank you, sir.